What's up, Miami Heat fans? Your boy Ernest here. I am back with another Miami Heat Talk video. Happy Friday, guys. Hope everybody's enjoying your day. Hope you guys are ready for the matchup tomorrow against the New York Knicks. Before we get started, I'm going to ask you guys to do me a quick favor. Smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys so much. We hit another plateau. We just hit 2,800 subscribers. 200 away from the big 3,000. I need you guys' help to get there. Help your boy out. I got something special for you guys when we get there. Okay. Few things I want to talk to you guys about. First and foremost, Heat fans, I want y'all to be happy. I know it's tough. I know we've lost 5 straight. I know Heat fans are upset. I know Heat fans are worried. I know you got some bitch-ass people in the comments just trolling Miami Heat. Happy the fact on how we've not been succeeded. I'll tell you, Heat fans, right now, don't worry about the haters. Don't worry about people saying that the Heat are down in the dumps. Because here's the great news. We were at the same point last year. And what did we do last season, you guys? We went to the 2023 NBA Finals. We shocked the world. So for all the people that are saying that the Miami Heat are done, remember, it was the same people saying the same stuff last year. And what happened? Every time the Heat won a series, those people that would talk smack, they would just disappear. That's exactly what's going to happen this season, you guys. We know how the Heat are. We want all the smoke. Bring us the smoke. We love it because we can handle it. Now, I got some good news for you, Heat fans, because today it was announced that tomorrow, our dude, Juan Wick, Jimmy Butler Jr., Jaime Jaquez Jr., will return to action tomorrow. And I'll be honest with you guys, we've lost 5 straight, and those 5 games we didn't have Jaime Jaquez Jr. People may call me crazy, but he's a big piece to this team. In my opinion, he's the 4th best player that we have. He's been showing it all year long. We need him out there. So with Jaime Jaquez Jr. against the New York Knicks, I like our chances. I think we're going to pull this one out, you guys. I like us against New York. Jalen Brunson's a beast, but this is going to be one hell of a matchup. Tomorrow, watch that game, you guys. Now, we're going to talk about something, you guys, and I'm going to throw an idea for you guys because I've been watching the team. I've been checking us out all season long, and you guys know me. I'm a huge supporter of this team. I don't care how bad we are with Eric Spoelstra, Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, and these boys. I like our chances against anyone in a 7-game series. We just got to be fully healthy, and we got to have the right pieces around us. Why am I saying that? Last night, against the game in Boston. Excuse me, the game against Boston. I noticed we were lacking one huge thing. We're going to use the word huge. We're going to use the word big. Because this is getting annoying. If there's one thing I'm noticing about the Miami Heat season, we get killed in the boards, man. We're getting killed in the rebounds, and you guys know why. We've been talking about it all season long. We don't have a true center. Now, we have Bam Adebayo, and I understand that people are like, Bam's too small, and I get this hate that Bam's getting, but in my opinion, he's top 5 center in the NBA. But he's not a center. He's a power forward. We saw this when he first started with the Heat. He was backing up Hassan Whiteside, but we saw when he dominated in the 2019-2020 season. Where was he playing? Power forward, next to Kelly Olynyk or Myles Leonard. I love Bam Adebayo in that position. It's his natural position. It allows him to be flexible to guard more positions if he has a 7-foot center out there with him. We've been clamoring this for years. We haven't had it since 2020. We've had fillers, PJ Tucker, Caleb Martin, Haywood Highsmith, Kevin Love. We've even thrown Jimmy Butler in there sometimes. We've never had a true big next to Bam. Now, if you ask me, does that mean we're not going to win the NBA Finals? No. I think with this roster fully healthy, we're going to get it together. You guys, it's just the second game with Terry Rozier out there. I understand that we've lost 5 straight and people are hitting the panic button and that we've lost 2 of them with Terry Rozier. But what happens when you get a new player in the middle of the season? They need to get acclimated. They need to get it together. It's not just going to be bam the first day. You've seen teams that get together their first year and they do good. It's because they have a training camp together. When you're trading in the middle of the season, you guys, it's really hard to get chemistry together. It takes a little bit of time. Sometimes you lose games. Unfortunately, when we traded for Terry Rozier, we were already on a 3-game losing streak. So now that we lost 2 games after that, everybody's pushing the panic button because we lost with Rozier. I don't think it's that big of a deal. This happens sometimes in the season. Sometimes you get on a winning streak. Sometimes you get on a losing streak. You just got to get it together. Jimmy Butler's annoyed. I'm sure they're going to kill each other in practice. This is the type of game that the Heat need. And my God, if you guys have been watching the Heat as long as I have, you're going to know exactly what I'm talking about. But for those of you youngins that don't remember this, I'll explain. 2006, the Miami Heat pulled off one of the biggest roster overhauls this NBA has ever seen. We had Wade and Shaq. We got Antoine Walker, James Posey, Jason Williams, Gary Payton, and we re-signed Alonzo Mourning. And that was with Udonis Haslem, Wade, and Shaq. On paper, this team should have won 79 games. You have multiple all-stars, multiple dominant players. It didn't work the first half of the season. The Heat were 500 the first 20 games. And there was this one game in February that they got that ass whooped by the Dallas Mavericks. By over 40 points they lost. And on that game, it was the middle of the season. After that game, they had a huddle. They started calling each other out. They started getting in each other's faces. And then things turned around because it was their first year together. They were getting acclimated and it wasn't working. I think that game last night against Boston was the same thing. I think Spo got in their ass. I think the fact that Udonis Haslem's not there anymore is another reason why this crap is happening. I'm sure they're going to call UD to come in and fix that problem. Be the cap. People need to step up. People need to call each other out. So do I think that this team should make a trade? No, but you need to address the problem that you have. Now, another thing that I was noticing last night, you guys, and I wanted to pose this question for you guys. Terry Rozier and Tyler Herro basically do the same thing. Now, I've called many times, one of them should come off the bench. The reason why is because we could really use that firepower. I think it's time to put Jaime Jaquez in the starting lineup. Put him as the starting shooting guard. Have Terry Rozier or Tyler Herro start at the one. And that way, you are getting a dangerous scorer coming off your bench. The question is, would either of them do that? Because both of them in the backcourt, now look, it's only 2 games. I get it. But both of them in the backcourt, they both played similar type of games. I think it'd be a lot better if Tyler came off the bench. You put Jaime Jaquez Jr. as a starting two. He's better defensively. He can hold his own. He can guard the best guard while Terry Rozier or Tyler Herro have the offensive presence. With this roster, that's what I feel would work. I love me Tyler Herro. I'm cool with Terry Rozier. I think together in the backcourt, it's not the best fit. I think Jaime Jaquez Jr. or Duncan Robinson would be better because now you're having a player who doesn't need the ball in his hands. Both Tyler and Terry Rozier do. And hello, Bam and Jimmy play the same way. It's only one ball. So in my opinion, with this roster, that's the way that you fix it. You got to talk to Rozier or Tyler and say, one of y'all needs to come off the bench. Who's going to do it? Because with them together in the starting lineup, I don't know if this will continue to work. Now, what's the other issue? You have a power forward who's 6'4" starting in Haywood Highsmith. You got a center in Bam Adebayo who's 6'9". Porzingis was eating these dudes up. Dude is 7'3". I'm going to give Boston mad credit, you guys. I know we hate Boston. I know Boston and Miami's a rivalry. But yo, real recognizes real. And it's all love, baby. What Boston did with that Porzingis trade made him dangerous. Made him a lot better. Way better. So now what you need to do is you need to combat that. What can you do to challenge Porzingis? Yeah, you could throw Bam on him, but a lot of times they were switching up. So Porzingis was either with Jimmy or Highsmith. Didn't work. He had a field day against those guys until he injured his ankle. That's going to happen again in the playoffs. You need to find something to match up against that. That's not going to be Thomas Bryant. It's not going to be Kevin Love. Bam Adebayo can only do as much as he can. The Miami Heat should start considering making a trade. And I've talked about this before. Make a trade. You really can't make another trade right now. The only trade that you can do is Caleb Martin, who has the highest contract. Unless the Miami Heat are willing to go all in with this roster and fully upgrade it. How do you do that? I don't want to do this. I don't want to say this. But I think we need to start thinking about trading Tyler Herro. When teams lose these many games in a row, sometimes you have to think about making a change. We have a lot of guards on this team and a lot of guys who play multiple positions and are short. Terry Rozier, Tyler Herro, Jaime Jaquez Jr., Caleb Martin, Haywood Highsmith. These are five guys that can play multiple positions, anywhere from the two to the four, right? Good. But we also have Duncan Robinson as well. You have a lot of guys that you can plug and play. If you're able to come up with a trade for Tyler Herro and get a starting center, a guy who's 6'10 to 7 feet tall, who can rebound, who can score, who can hit the three-point shot, then that's going to make this team better. Why Tyler? It's not because I have a problem with Tyler, you guys. I don't want this to come off the wrong way. I love Tyler Herro. I want Tyler Herro to stay on this team. But here's what I'm going to tell you. He's making the most money, so you can get a star-quality player with the salary that he has. You can also trade Duncan Robinson. But I think if you're dangling Duncan or Tyler, you're going to get a bigger response with Tyler. Tyler shows that he can score the hell out of the ball. He may not be the best defensively, but for a rebuilding team, he can be one of the focal points moving forward. We know that. I love him on this roster. But if you ask me, you guys, if we trade Tyler Herro versus, not Jimmy, not Bam, but if you trade Tyler Herro, you can automatically plug any one of these players into the starting lineup with Terry Rozier. Automatically. We saw it when Tyler was out. We won 7 straight games when Duncan Robinson is the starting 2. If you trade Tyler Herro and you get somebody to start next to Bam, and you put Duncan Robinson, Terry Rozier, Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, and that now starting center or power forward, that makes this team better. Tyler and Terry Rozier play the same thing. And I think, you guys, this trade was made. I think the Heat are thinking about that. Because why would you get a guy who plays exactly the same game as Tyler Herro? I understand you upgraded the roster, but now you made it a little bit more difficult with the offense if you're going to start them both. But let's say if the Heat trade Tyler Herro to another team for a center or a power forward, it makes this team a whole hell of a lot better because we got the two things that we needed. Starting point guard, and a big man. Ladies and gentlemen, there's no rumors, there's nothing out there, but I have an idea. And it's something that a lot of you have been saying in the comments recently. I think the Miami Heat need to call the Utah Jazz and go all in on Lauri Markkanen. And when I say all in, you guys, there's not a lot that we can give. We traded Kyle Lowry and a future first round draft pick to Charlotte. So all we have left is our 2020 first round pick. But if you call the Utah Jazz, and let's be honest, Tyler Herro and Lauri Markkanen's numbers, they don't match. Lauri Markkanen makes $17 million. Tyler makes $27 million. But if you call Utah and you ask for Lauri Markkanen and Kelly Olynyk, and you offer them Tyler Herro, Nikola Jovic, and that 2030 future first round draft pick, that's an offer. Does it get done? Probably not. But if I'm the Miami Heat, that's what I'm looking to do. I'm looking around and seeing what center, what power forward's available, who has a potential all-star or somebody who's hanging around that area, somebody that can help us fit that. Because I'm telling you guys, if you trade Duncan Robinson, what can you really get? Can you get an all-star quality player? Probably not. Tyler Herro fits that mold. I'm not saying I want to trade Tyler. I'm saying you can get a better center or power forward for Tyler. Rather than Duncan. Maybe you can get a better one for Duncan. If you can, go fine. Duncan, okay. I think Duncan's a better piece on this team. I don't think Duncan's a better player than Tyler Herro. I think on this Miami Heat roster with Bam Adebayo, Jimmy Butler, Terry Rozier, if you start Tyler Herro or Duncan Robinson, I think this offense works better with Duncan Robinson. And a matter of fact, the only plus average the Miami Heat have been getting since Terry Rozier has been here has been the lineup of Terry Rozier, Duncan Robinson, Jimmy Butler, Caleb Martin, and Bam Adebayo. When that when those five are on the court, they're always a plus. So that's something to think about, Heat fans. So now I want to pose the question to you guys. Do you think if we trade Tyler Herro, that's going to give us the missing piece that we need? Do you think we have to make a trade at all? Do you think this roster will be fine and this is just a bad side and things will come up? And if we and if you do think we need to make the trade, do you think we can actually get Lauri Markkanen? Or is there somebody else you would like to see? Let me know in the comments what you think, you guys. Don't forget to smash the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for tuning in, you guys. If I hear any other updates or anything, I will definitely let you know. Hope you guys have a great weekend. Your boy Ernest out. That's enough said. Let's go, Heat.